this time I'll be lucky. Maybe this time he'll stay. Maybe this time, for the first time, love won't hurry away. He will hold me fast. I'll be home at last. Not a loser anymore, like the last time and the time before. Everybody loves a winner, so nobody loved me. Lady peaceful, lady happy, that's what I long to be. Love's a winner, so nobody loved me. Lady peaceful, lady happy, that's what I long to be. It's gonna happen. Happen sometime. Maybe this time. Maybe this time I'll win.
Decided to cook my husband on the day he left me. The day he left me, I cried for 16 hours solid. When I looked in the mirror, my skin was all blotchy and I just thought, he's done this to you. Him. Of course, when your husband leaves you, the word bastard comes to mind in big, bold letters. It starts to form itself silently underneath your breath. Then you're muttering it underneath your breath and whispering it vehemently, trying to spit out every single consonant. And it builds and builds and gets louder and louder until before you know it, you're screaming at the top of your lungs, bastard! You'll know what I mean when your husband leaves you. Oh, look. Here's bastard now. Bang on time as usual. That's the one thing I can say about our 19 years of relationship. The man was always punctual. Oh, look, and she's here too. Her. It. Huh, they must have come for dinner. How lovely. I suppose I better let them in. Actually, no. They can wait. I dropped her off that night, about a quarter or two. I should have asked her to come over, or at least asked her if anything was wrong, but she seemed normal. Not happy exactly, but like herself. I first met her in freshman year, in Introduction to British Literature. We made each other laugh. She was bitter, cynical, but still really nice. I knew she had depression, but we had so much fun together, you know? I'll never actually get my head around that. That night, we saw a play and watched a midnight movie. I was falling asleep though, because I'd been up really early that morning to go running, and I keep wondering if there was something we saw in the play or the movie, some sort of trigger, some reason. Something that set her off, something I missed. And I keep looking for clues, for answers. She'd survived so much. Why that night?
Just a bit.